So as you know, Wednesday nights I share a devotional that's based on an Alelo Hawaii word, a word from the Hawaiian language, along with several related scriptures. And I've been doing this as a weekly blog on the church website. My hope is to eventually write enough of them to have a 365-day devotional book with that information. If you think you might be interested in getting a devotional like that, let me know in the comments. We'll make sure we keep you posted as we get closer to a publication time for that. So today's Alelo Hawaii word is the name for our Judeo-Christian God. In Hawaii, we say Akua, Akua. Akua in the Hawaiian language, of course, can refer to any number of gods, just like our English word God can refer to many different understandings or many different belief systems. But when it's used here in Hawaii, when we capitalize it here, Akua, it's understood as Christians we're referring to the one true God that we know. And you know, it shouldn't bother us to call God by this different name because the Bible is full of many different names for God. We read El Shaddai, Elohim, Yahweh, Adonai. That's just a few of them. For example, El Shaddai, that's a name that means God Almighty. Elohim, the plural of God, is the God of reverence and awe. Adonai means Lord. Yahweh simply means I am all of existence. Yahweh Yireh means God my provider. Yahweh Nisi means God my banner. Yahweh Ra'ah means God my shepherd. Yahweh Shalom means God my peace. Yahweh M'kadesh means God who sanctifies. Yahweh Rophe means the God who heals. El Elyon, the God most high. El Kana, the jealous God. El Olam, the eternal God. Yahweh Bara, the creator God. God's also called in scripture the fortress, the rock, the shield, the horn of my salvation. Yahweh Sabaoth, the Lord of hosts. Yahweh Uzi, God my strength. On and on and on the Hebrew names of God go. In a similar way, we know Jesus as Lord, Savior, Messiah, Christ, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Lord of Hosts, Emmanuel, God with us. He's called Logos, the divine word. He's called the Son of God. He's called the Son of Man. He's called Master and Rabbi. He's called the second Adam, the Alpha, the Omega, the first, the last, the arm of God. He's called the Amen, the author, the finisher of our faith, the cornerstone, the good shepherd, the way, the truth, the life, the creator, the dayspring, the deliverer, the desire of nations, the faithful witness. We shared on Sunday, he's called Wonderful Counselor, God Almighty, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Jesus is called the Great High Priest, the Head of the Church, the Holy One of God, the Judge, the Lamb of God, the Lion of the Tribe of Judah, the Lily of the Valley, the Light of the World, the Morning Star. He's called our Passover, our Redeemer, the Rock, the Root of David, and the Rose of Sharon, Son of David, the True Light, the True Vine, the Son of Righteousness, and many, many more. Of course, Yehoshua or Yeshua, the true Hebrew name of Jesus, which means salvation, that's my favorite name to use when I think of Jesus. I have to say, though, I really love this Hawaiian name of Akua as well. Our God is Akua. So let's talk about four characteristics of our Akua tonight based on the Word of God. The first one is this. Our Akua is omnibeneficent. Omnibeneficent. That means all good or all loving. One of the first phrases I learned after moving here to Hawaii was Aloha Ke Akua, which can be understood as with the love of God. It's like how you would sign an email, or God's love, or in God's love, or it could be translated God is love. Now, of course, this is a supremely powerful idea and one I want to challenge you to prayerfully meditate on today. What does that mean to you? Aloha ke akua. Well, the Apostle John was arguably Jesus' best friend on earth. No one has more insight into the core nature and character of God the Father than Jesus did. And John hung out with Jesus a lot, so we can really trust what John shares with us. John wrote these words in 1 John 4, verse 8. We shared these recently in another message as well. He says, "Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love." God is love. We shared that scripture, I think it was two Sundays ago. The Apostle John is making a very bold statement here when he says, if you do not love others, then you cannot possibly know God. Why is that true? It's because love is the very core nature of God's character. Love does not exist outside of God. So you can't claim to know God if you are incapable of loving, right? So let me ask you first, do you realize just how much God loves you today? Are you aware of how much God loves you today? He loves you so much that he sent Jesus, his only begotten son, to die for you, even when you had set yourself up against him as an enemy. That's some pretty amazing love. You know, as a pastor, I often see people struggle with this idea that they are lovable, that they're loved by God. Many people seem to really doubt that. They doubt that God loves them. And so I see people come to church still filled with shame and guilt and regrets. And people sometimes express their worry to me this way. They'll say something like, Greg, if you really knew who I am, if you really knew everything I've done, you wouldn't love me. And my answer is simple. I say, well, if you really knew who I am and everything I've done, you wouldn't be worried, right? We've all done things that we wish we hadn't done. We've all done unlovable things. But God already knows exactly who you are. He knows exactly what you think. He knows exactly everything you've done. And still he chooses to love you. And he says, you are worthy of my love. You are a lovable person. You are loved by Akua. Regardless of what you've come to believe about Akua in your own life experience, regardless of what you have been taught, the Akua I know, the God I know, when he thinks of you, overflowing love bursts from his heart and a giant smile overwhelms his face. Why? Because Aloha Ke Akua, God is love. The second question I want you to ask yourself tonight is, how easily do you love others? Does loving and forgiving and blessing others come easy to you, or is it a hard thing to do? Jesus said this in Matthew chapter 5. We're going to be looking at this in a couple of Sundays from now. He says, you have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Why? So that you may be sons of your Father who is in heaven. For he causes his sun to rise on the evil and the good, and sends rain on the righteous and the unrighteous. For if you love those who love you, what reward do you have? Do not even the tax collectors do the same? If you greet only your brothers, what more are you doing than others? Do not even the Gentiles do the same? Therefore, you are to be perfect as your heavenly Father is perfect. Jesus is saying, if you love only those who are acting in loving ways toward you, you're not walking in the footsteps of your Akua. To fully describe and comprehend God is impossible for us to grasp, and yet we get so many clues to who our Akua is in the Scriptures. And again, we're just hitting on four of them. We just said our Akua is omnibeneficent. He's all loving. He's all good. The second thing we know about our Akua is he is omnipotent. He is all powerful. The prophet Jeremiah wrote these words in Jeremiah 32, verse 17. He says, O sovereign Lord, you have made the heavens and earth by your great power. Nothing is too hard for you. You see, the Bible tells us Akua simply spoke and created all of time and space. That's an amazing thing to think about, because astronomers estimate our universe has more than 100 billion galaxies, and Akua created it all just with a spoken word. He can do anything, anything. In your life, no need is too great. No problem is too complicated. No prayer is too difficult to answer. He can do anything. Nothing is too hard for him. That's great news for you, because as I said a few moments ago, this all-powerful Akua loves you. And he has a plan and a purpose for your life. No matter how tough things are for you right now, no matter what you might be faced with tonight, I promise you, Akua can help you. Akua can solve your problem, whatever it is. Akua can meet your need, whatever it is. Akua can heal you. Akua can support you, whatever you need. Akua can guide you wherever you need to go. Look at what Paul says in Ephesians 3, verse 20. He says, by his mighty power at work within us, he is able to accomplish infinitely more than we would ever dare to ask or even dream. Why is that? It's because God can do anything you can do, anything that he commands you to do. Let me say that again. Because God can do anything you can do anything that he commands you to do. Whatever he calls you to do, whatever he commands you to do, it must be possible for you to do it, because God would never set you up to fail. He wants you to succeed in everything he commands you to do. Look at what he says in Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for calamity, to give you a future and a hope. When you read those words and you realize they apply to you, how does that make you feel? Does that encourage you? Does that lift you up? Boy, it should. What's your greatest need tonight? What's your greatest need right this moment? Pour your heart out to Akua, the all-powerful one. Express your need to him and know that he will meet your need. So we're talking about these four big characteristics of Akua. So far we've said, number one, our Akua is omnibeneficent. He is all good. He's all loving. Number two, our Akua is omnipotent. He's all powerful. And now number three, our Akua is omnipresent. He's always with us. King David wrote these words in Psalm 139. He asks, where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me. Your right hand will hold me fast. If I say, surely the darkness will hide me and the light become night around me, even the darkness will not be dark to you. The night will shine like the day, for darkness is as light to you. You know, maybe during this global pandemic, you've been feeling isolated. Maybe you've been feeling lonely. Maybe you've even been feeling forgotten. But I'm here to tell you tonight, Akua is never absent from you. He's always present with you. He'll never forget about you. God is always with you because he is an infinite spirit. He's not restricted to being in one location at a time, or even one time at a time. In fact, because he is existence itself, all of space and time are contained within him. Think of him as an infinite ocean, and all of creation as a small sponge submerged in the middle of the ocean called God. He fills every inch of space and time, every atom of matter throughout the universe and within the universe with all of his wonderful personal attributes. So even though God is distinct from his creation, all of his creation exists within him, and he exists within all of his creation. The Apostle Paul said it this way in Acts 17, verse 27 and 28. He says, he is not far from each one of us. For in him we live and move and exist. And then, of course, you probably certainly know John 3:16, but do you know 1 Corinthians 3:16? Paul reminds us, don't you know that you yourselves are God's temple and that God's Spirit lives in you? And Jesus himself reminded us at the end of the Great Commission. He says, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. God always sees us. God always hears us. God always knows us. God is always with us. So if you ever feel alone, if you ever feel far from God, guess who moved? Guess who moved? You did. He's never going to move away from you. God will never move away from you. God wants you to interact with him throughout the day, every day. He wants you to not only be aware of him, but to engage with him. God is always only a whisper away from you. But maybe you're a little like me. Maybe if you're like me, sometimes you get so preoccupied with life and the struggles that you forget about God. I'll confess to you, I do that sometimes. I forget to talk to him. I forget to lean on him. I try to sort of take care of things myself. And that's when he taps me on my heart to remind me that he's still with me, that he's never left. I've often wondered, you know, why do we so often pray, dear Lord, be with us, when he promised he would never leave us? That doesn't make any sense. He's always right here, never far away. Sometimes, even though we're working hard for him, we tend to cut him out of the process. We get so busy in the work of the Lord that we forget the Lord of the work. So again, we're talking about four attributes of Akua. We've covered three of the four so far. Number one, our Akua is omnibeneficent. He's all good. He's all loving. Number two, our Akua is omnipotent. He's all powerful. Number three, our Akua is omnipresent. He's always with us. And then we have one more. Number four, our Akua is omniscient. He's all-knowing. Now, we just read a passage from Psalm 139 a little bit ago about the omnipresence of God. But before David wrote about the omnipresence of God, in the first six verses of that psalm, David wrote about the omniscience of God. Let's look at those verses together. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You understand my thought from afar. You scrutinize my path and my lying down and are intimately acquainted with all my way. Even before there is a word on my tongue, behold, O Lord, you know it all. You have enclosed me behind and before and laid your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is too high. I cannot attain to it. You see, Akua knows everything there is to know. Again, all of time, all of space, all of knowledge, all of wisdom exists within him. He is existence itself. He is the source of all knowledge, of all wisdom, of all understanding. So obviously, he never misunderstands. He never mistakes. He never suffers from a wrong perspective or incomplete facts. His knowledge, his perspective, his opinion, his point of view, his decisions are always completely true and 100% accurate. Akua knows the answers to all of life's questions. Akua is never surprised or bewildered. He's completely aware of all events, past, present, and future. So obviously, he also knows everything about you. He knows all your desires, all your motives, all your thoughts. God knows more about you than you will ever possibly know about yourself. The author of Hebrews tells us in Hebrews 4:13, "There is no creature hidden from his sight, but all things are open and laid bare to the eyes of him with whom we have to do." Akua knows your likes, your dislikes, your good deeds, your sins. He knows your words, your deeds, your thoughts. When you face challenges or difficulties, you can be encouraged that your God understands what you are going through. We've been talking about this a lot in recent Sunday messages and Wednesday messages, and I think I said last time this has become an often recurring passage over the last month or so. It's just a really in-tune part of where we are in Scripture. So let's look at it again. Three more verses from Hebrews 4 that occur right after the one we just read. Verse 14, "Therefore, because of what we just read, since we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus the Son of God, let us hold fast to our confession. For we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who has been tempted in all things as we are, yet without sin. Therefore, let us draw near with confidence to the throne of grace, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in time of need." All that means, Akua, Jesus, he knows about all of your pressures and problems as a human being. He knows about the purpose for your trials. He never wastes a hurt. Whenever you go through a struggle, whenever you go through a tough time, I guarantee you God will bring something good out of it. Look at what Paul says in Romans 5. "We also glory in our sufferings because we know that suffering produces perseverance, perseverance character, and character hope. And hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us." And so here we are, back where we started again, back at love again. Aloha ke Akua. God is love. You know, I've said this several weeks in a row. I'm going to say it again. I am certainly not a perfect man. Far from it. I'm certainly not a perfect pastor. Far from it. But this is my promise always to you. I'll always give everything I've got to help you become everything that God has called and created you to be. Aloha. I share my life, I share my breath, I share my spirit with you. Let's pray together. Father God, I thank you for this understanding of who you are. Here in Hawaii, we call you Akua, but we could call you by any of these other names or titles in Scripture. They all give us one tiny aspect of your infinite qualities, infinite character, your infinite wisdom, your infinite power, your all presence, your amazing love, your goodness and greatness. God, help us just get a little glimpse of who you are today, a little better glimpse, I should say. Help us know you a little more tonight than we did before we started this worship service tonight. Help us go to bed tonight feeling like we have a better grasp of how all-powerful and all-knowing and all-loving and all-present you always are. Help us take encouragement from that idea, from that knowledge. Help us feel your presence close to us tonight. Hug everyone who needs a hug right now, Lord, with your Holy Spirit. Let them know that they are loved and that you are still large and in charge of your universe. They don't have to be afraid. Encourage everyone with that tonight, Lord. That's my prayer for all of us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.